the reality of war to a lot of people. Somebody else makes them be involved, and they're just trying to get on with their lives.
I once did an interview live on radio where people could ask questions about Alo Alo, and one man came on live and told me that he was a member of the Polish resistance in the war, and I thought, oh dear, what am I going to say? And what he amazed me by saying was that he thought our series was more realistic than serious films about resistance. you would not have been able to do what you did without a sense of humour. And also, there were lots of, if you understand this expression, cock-ups, where things went wrong all the time. And he said, our show showed that, which was more realistic. And it wasn't, not everything was successful.
Но всъщност той ми каза, че смята, че сериалът е доста по-добре отразява войната, отколкото много сериозни филми, защото на първо място човек не би могъл да прави това, което те прави без чувство за хумор, да оцелее и да преживее това без чувство за хумор, и второ, защото има много гафове и такива ситуации, които.
I also live in France as well as the UK, and my bank manager said to me, I want you to meet my mother, Rochelle. She actually worked for the resistance. And I couldn't believe it when I met her. She was exactly like me, a pocket dynamo, about 4 foot 11, which she said was useful to keeping her ear to the ground.
I think almost everything has been said, but just a little parenthetical story. On the very first day of rehearsals for the pilot of this show, I went up in the lift with David Croft, with Jeremy Loy, and who was one of our two writers.
Ще ви кажа само една малка история. При пускането на един от първите епизоди се качи в асансьора с Джереми Лойд, който е един от двамата ни сценаристи.
And Kim mentioned to you earlier that the show, our show, was based on a long-running series called Secret Army about French resistance. And I said to Jeremy Lloyd, I think it's extraordinary of the BBC, really big-hearted of them to accept that we are going to send up one of their iconic shows.
И как вече споменахме, нашето шоу всъщност излезе след един дълго показан сериал, който се казваше Тайната армия. И аз казах на Джереми, това е много смело от страна на BBC да позволи нашия сериал да измести толкова показно Тайната армия.
He said, for fuck's sake, they tell them they hadn't noticed.
But in fact, there was another series of Secret Army that was due to be made, and it was
cancelled.
Като най-трудно се прави комедия и като голям фен на Лало, искам да благодаря на сценаристите за този генерален сериал, на актьорите, които ни доставиха толкова много усмивки и смях и забавление през годините, и им желая в София също много да се забавляват и да се радват на нашата признателност и благодарност и на невероятния превод на Златна Коса. Благодарим ви!
Да, отговорът е, че той е бил права.
един сериал, който има толкова много сезони, е много важно постоянно да бъдат добавени свежи лица и свежи герои.
There was a story about how he came to be there.
And история за как се появи той.
I think they were passing through. It was something to do with the train. Anybody remember?
Имаше някакви истории с влак, който минаваше, някакви помни ли с вас?
And they were only meant to be there for on their way somewhere else. And he never left.
И всъщност трябваше да пътуваха за някъде героите, обаче той така и не си тръгна този капитан.
Too many attractive French women, I think it was that.
Май имаше прекалено много хубави французойки там.
Анджела.
We take that as bad. We take the assume that was true.
И предполагаме, че това си истина.
Може ли да попитам полицай кратки? Трудно ли му е да говори така забъркано и да само си ли се справи да полицай?
Everything was written in the script as I speak it. So it was a question of putting the stress on the word. So good mooning would be like good morning, or listen to moo, or listen to me. But you had to put the stress on the same part of the word as you would if you were speaking normally. But I don't know what it says about me, but I saw the script when I went for the interview and I thought, oh yes, I understand that. So I think that just makes me rather odd and probably why I got the part.
Част на изречението да се постави ударението, но аз взех търси сценария, когато отивах на кастинг и си мислях, аха, да, разбирам какво правиш, което може би е по-скоро рефлексира върху мен и моят здрав разум.
Здравейте, искам да кажа, че това от 7-8 години е любимия сценарий Алало. И да поздравя Хелки и Хелко, които са любимите режисьори. Да ви направим и така кратка сцена, ако е много, да се изкърваме на първо.
Беше към Херфлик и Хелга, които са най-малки.
Out of 10.